The Newport Seafood and Wine Festival, the entire Newport area for that matter, was so crazy and fun that we couldn't just bring you one show. So here we go with PDXposed Goes Coastal Part 2. Heather's not with us today. She's decided to spend more time building her brand new family. However, she will be with us from time to time as a special segment host. So look forward to that. On the next episode of PDXposed, we'll introduce you to a brand new co-host. So please join us on the next show. Speaking of shows, there is tons. This is an action-packed show, so I'm going to get out of here and let you guys see it for yourself. But I need to tell you who our band is. Rye Hollow, a very talented band from Troutdale, Oregon, filmed right here at the Doug Fir Lounge. Don't touch that dial. PDXposed Goes Coastal, Part 2. We'll be right back.
PDXposed is brought to you by PDX Magazine, Portland's where-to-go, what-to-do guide featuring live music, restaurants, nightlife, local sports, and latest trends. Pick up this month's issue today or download your free copy at PDXMagazine.com.
For our in-motion segment on this show, we're going crabbing today, courtesy of Seagull Charters. I've never been crabbing. I have no idea what to expect. Let's go meet the captain. You're the captain.
I'm the captain. Hi, John. I'm Rick.
Rick.
My name's Rick. This is Gene, my deckhand. He's going to be doing a lot of the work for you, too. He's going to be getting wet, if there's any getting wet involved. We have a life raft up here that will deploy automatically if anything bad should happen. If you see smoke, holler before you bail out, because we'll be bailing out with you.
What are you wearing?
I'm wearing some Grundins, and before we get out there, we're going to set you up with a pair.
I'll wear them.
All right.
I'm always game.
All right. In fact, I got a pair here ready for you.
Are they my size?
They are probably actually your size, because they're a little short for me.
How come I don't get the swanky orange ones, man?
Well, you know, they're reserved for the extreme people.
I'm not very extreme. All right.
There you go. You look like a regular deckhand.
Have Grundins, will crab.
That's right.
Let's get them.
Okay, let's go get some crabs.
Oh, yeah. Look at that. Pater, baby.
Oh, there's a couple of nice keepers in there. There's some big ones. It's that front end you got to worry about. They get a good hold on you, and they will draw blood, too.
So we're out fishing for crab today, but we can only keep the males, and we can only keep the males that are actually legal in the state of Oregon. And here's how we measure it. This little bad boy right here. 5 3/4 is what it has to fit. So it has to fit in between here, or we can't keep it. Washington, they're 6 1/4. California, they're 6 inches, 5 3/4 in Oregon. I don't know why the Oregon crabs should be smaller than the Washington and the California crabs. The rest of them. Throw it back.
Do you have to throw it back?
Yeah.
Oh. Bye bye. Let's see your mommy.
Okay.
Stop,
that's really good.
The best right now. Andre Hegestad. Did I say it right?
Yes, you did.
On the first try. Now you are the creator of The Beach Connection.
I'm their editor, yeah.
So we're here in Night Beach right now. So what would be the things that you would feature in your magazine or try to promote for the city?
Well, the big thing about our magazine is one of the big themes is beach secrets. And we're really good at, like, besides the fact it's really detailed, as is our website, which you can find at beachconnection.net. Our big thing is beach secrets, and Night Beach is actually sort of a big secret in itself. It's sort of less, even though if you want to go to the beach in Newport, you got to come out here.
This hotel over here.
Yeah. The Silly Beach Hotel. This is really interesting because every single room in there has a theme of an author. Like the Hemingway room, and it has like various Hemingway stuff from Hemingway's life and so on. The other interesting thing about this area is some of the beaches around here. There's especially Jump Off Joe. There's ruins there. They look like the ruins of a castle. So I was, you know, it's like the closest thing that the Central Coast has got to the ruins of a castle. It's really cool. This place is just phenomenal food. It's basically, there are a bunch of, the Trustee family is, they're a bunch of Northern Californians that came up here, and it's just fabulous food. Like the pate, my big joke is their pate is better than sex. And it's really, really good. What they call a small but proud wine shop, and there's like wines from all around the world here, but it sort of specializes in a lot of Oregon, Northwest wine and so on.
As a lot of you know, PDXposed was nominated for 2 Emmys. If we win, knock on wood, I have to get up in front of hundreds of my esteemed colleagues and do one of those acceptance speeches that you guys have all seen. So obviously, I gotta look good. A lot of you have been commenting on how cool my clothes have been lately. Brent from the showroom has been dressing me. I give him all the credit. So he's actually agreed to get me suited up for the Emmys in style. Let's go meet Brent.
My name's Brent Collier. I'm the owner of the showroom. We've been in downtown Portland for about 12 years. We're located at Southwest 9th Avenue in Alder, above Rich's. We have great service. We have great product knowledge. A lot of us have been in this business for a very long time. We're very into it. We have ingredients. There's a backstory to everything. It's just not clothing and you look great and this is it and it's this and you should buy it. You know, it's something more to that to me. I really like this. Look at this. I mean, I love the way this fits you. I think it's definitely really cool. But if guys are going to be in tuxes, the Emmys, from what I've seen of it, I think we should dress it up just a little bit. Pink's the color now. We're going to try this. Whoa. You're very dressy with the suit, but I like the lightness with the blue, with your color, with the pop, not being like everybody else. I think that's perfect. I think we got it, my friend.
Yeah.
Deal or no deal?
Deal.
I really enjoy being out and seeing my customer out amongst in an event or in a restaurant. Their feeling about the clothes, the way they wear it, the innate style. I'm just glad. I'm really proud of who shops here and who I see shopping here.
Don't go away. PDXposed goes coastal. We'll be right back. PDXposed is brought to you by PDX Magazine. Portland's where to go, what to do guide featuring live music, restaurants, nightlife, local sports, and latest trends. Pick up this month's issue today or download your free copy at pdxmagazine.com.
Brown, sports director for KATU-TV, and you're watching PDXposed.
If you comb the beaches in Lincoln City, you might just be lucky enough to find your very own glass float. Glass floats have been huge along the Oregon coast since the late 1990s. Kelly joins us from the Jennifer L. Sears Glass Art Studio, and today we get to make our very own glass float. Tell us about the studio here and what people can come and do and what they can find.
They can come and blow a glass float or a paperweight, or there's some other things that they can do here.
You're going to make some other things with us today. You're going to do a starfish with us, right?
Right. Yeah. And you can pick your colors that you want to choose, you know, whatever colors you want. We kind of guide you. There's certain colors that don't go together so well that turn brown because of the heat and the chemicals. So we try to steer you towards colors that go well together.
Tell us about the history of glass floats along, especially in Lincoln City. It's really big here.
Right. Well, in the year, I guess in 1999, Brian Duncan came down and introduced this idea of hiding floats on the beach for the year 2000, the millennium floats. So they hid 2,000 floats in Lincoln City, and then it's just become a tradition.
We're going to go do a glass float,
yep.
Starfish,
yep. Heart.
A paperweight, and a heart.
Yeah.
How sweet. Kelly, thanks. Let's go do it.
Okay.
Here at the Jennifer L. Sears Glass Art Gallery, we just blow it. That's what we do here. You too can blow your very own glass float at the corner of 48th and Highway 101 in Lincoln City.
I'm here with Scott, who hooked PD Exposed up with Bella Beach Rentals this weekend. Scott, you're the operations manager for Bella Beach.
You know it.
Tell us about all the homes, because there's plenty of them here.
Well, we take care of 52 homes here, and they range from oceanfront to just a short walk to the beach. And they have hot tubs, fireplaces, some of them are pet friendly, and they go from 2 bedrooms to 5 bedrooms. This home that we're standing in right now is a 3-story, 3.5-bathroom, 3-bedroom, 1,800 square foot townhouse. The 2-bedroom homes can range from about 1,000 square feet up to, say, 1,600 square feet.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
This is a beautiful place.
Hey, enjoy your stay.
Heather and I are taking a little break at the wine festival. It's going on full bore in there, but we're coming outside to drink a little bit of wine, and I got to ask Heather a few questions. First question, Heather, is how many wine festivals have there been? Do you know?
29.
You got that in the interview, didn't you?
Yeah.
I didn't hear your interview, but he told you.
No, the glass
cheater.
Is 29th annual.
Did you hear that? This is what's going on at the wine festival. People can't really talk so clearly. Why is that, Heather?
First glass. Well,
a little bit of wine?
It's called self-control, and nobody here has it. Exactly.
I'm surrounded here in a girl sandwich at the Seafood and Wine Festival. I'm going to ask you guys questions individually, starting with you. Spell Depot Bay.
D-E-P-O-E-B-A-Y.
Jackpot. Way to go. Spell Depot Bay.
D-E-P-O-T-B-A-Y.
D-E-P-O-T-B-A-Y.
D-E-P-O-E.
No, it is not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
No, it isn't.
Is that a Depot Bay?
There's an E.
No way.
I'm dead serious.
No way.
The mayor of Depot Bay is going to be pissed that you guys don't know how to spell Depot Bay.
I'm sorry, Depot Bay.
Depot Bay, yeah. That's
no, it's P-O-E.
Oh, he's going to be angry at us.
Who's the president of the United Emirates?
I have no idea.
Neither do I. I just wondered if you knew. What does my mic flex say?
PDX Exposed.
There's one that's wrong. Thank you for that. See, it's actually PDXposed. Why do girls go to the bathroom in packs?
Oh. because we got to do our makeup.
It's safer that way.
Girls are very critical of each other.
Yes.
We'll always tell each other the truth about what you look like, what we look like.
Listen, if you're out on the dance floor and you're sweating up some major, you know, you got to do your makeup.
Why do girls go to the bathroom in packs?
Conversation immediately to gossip about anything and everything that's going on.
Everything that just happened. We need time to reconvene and discuss everything that just happened.
Yeah. So what's the number one thing that's happened today that you've gossiped about in the bathroom?
How long the person before us took in the bathroom?
Well, I would assume by the end of this day, girls, you're gonna have a lot more to gossip about.
Jerry, Seafood Wine Fest. Now, I see you guys have plenty of beads. What is that for exactly?
They give us the beads when we drink wine.
Every time we buy wine, they give us beads.
Now, there's a lot of hot chicks here. Isn't that what really draws you to this thing?
Well, this is our first time, actually.
You're virgins.
Yes, we are. This is our first time, so we're having a lot of fun.
Everybody loves your wine.
Our wines are great. We have really great wines and they're affordably priced and people really appreciate that.
One of the many food venues here at the Seafood and Wine Fest, the Wild Mushroom Soup, which I'm going to sample. You get this? Good. Don't know if I'm going to be feeling a little hallucinogenic here in about a half an hour, but
You got this funky little white wine here.
Late Harvest Chardonnay. It's a sweet dessert wine. It's very tasty. My husband, who is the winemaker, put a little bit of Viognier in it. It's very, very nice. If you like sweet wines, it's wonderful.
Bad Girl Blanc.
It's a still fermented Chardonnay, so it's very crisp, very clean, very appealing. Goes very versatile, goes real with food or without.
All right, I think we're going to do a cheers. And of course, you have to have some. Thank you, Renee. Cheers, hot chicks. That's good.
What's hot at Relax the Back, folks? The Z Swing Recliner Chair. This chair gently rocks you back and forth while giving you all the benefits of zero gravity. It comes in a gazillion colors, and it actually rocks you back and forth at the same rate as your resting heart rate, thus maximizing all the stress-reducing benefits. Feels like you're floating on air, folks, so float into one of the two Relax the Back locations in the Portland metropolitan area, or for more information, dial the number on the screen. Did you know that Depot Bay has the world's smallest harbor? Don't take my word for it. This local music segment is brought to you by Rockstar Energy Drink. I'm constantly amazed that the radio stations in Portland don't play more local Portland bands. We have so much talent, and the band here tonight, Rye Hollow, is definitely not an exception. However, these guys, unsigned as they are, have two songs in the Kink rotation, which is absolutely unheard of. So we're totally stoked that you guys are joining us. Thanks for joining us on PDXposed.
Yeah.
Let's go around the room and tell us who you are and what do you play first, and then we'll get into the questions.
Kevin O'Loughlin, I play guitar.
Brianna Paletta, and I sing and play guitar.
Andy Uppendahl, and I play drums.
Chris Chard, I play bass.
Let's talk about your name, Rye Hollow. I thought you were Rye Hollow, Brianna. I thought, like, Rye Hollow, that's an interesting name. Why would her parents name her Rye Hollow? How did the name come about?
It's actually the name of an old road in Virginia, like an old country road. We just really like the sound of it. It kind of fit the vibe.
You're so beautiful, I'm giving back the dreams you sold me.
Let's talk about the process of putting something like this together. Right now, it's your release is here. I would assume it has to be this huge, heavy sigh of relief, like, oh my God, it's finally done. With it probably comes like some anxiety and some fear, like, how's it going to be received? This is our heart and soul. Let's go around the room and talk about those feelings.
Well, I guess as far as I'm concerned, you know, this is our baby, and we've put it together, and we've put everything into it. And personally, I care how it's received, but at the same time, I don't necessarily care how it's received, because it's our thing.
I've actually spent, I mean, a lot of personal time just, like, getting over, like, you know, music reviews, you know, if I'm in a project or just kind of in general. So I'm just, like, I've just really enjoyed playing in this band, and, I mean, I hope people really like it. I just know I'm confident. I feel like, you know, they're very heartfelt songs and, you know, real, just very, you know, interesting instrumentally, and I'm just, you know, people like it, great. If they don't, then, you know, whatever. So.
Well, Kink likes it.
I'm excited. I mean, it's been well received so far, so I think it'll be cool.
Yeah, I'm excited too. I think there's no anxiety from my point of view. I think, you know, we all believe in the music. We're actually going to go on our first tour out of state this summer, so we're going to go to Idaho and Washington, California, so we're all really excited about that. So I think, you know, if anything, we're more excited about getting the music out to folks, so...
We hope you enjoyed Rye Hollow in this special episode of PDXposed Goes Coastal Part 2. If you guys want to find out what's going on around Portland, pick up your copy of PDX Magazine today. This is truly Portland's where to go, what to do guide. You can find it at newsstands or download your copy at pdxmagazine.com. I want to give a huge thanks to our sponsors, PDX Magazine, Rockstar, Relax the Backstores, and of course, Comcast, Latitudes, London Influence, and my boy Brent at the showroom who got me all decked out for the Emmys. We'll see you next time on PDXposed. Make good memories, everybody.
Okay, let's go get some crabs.
Wow. That's usually not a good thing to say.
Hey, we're here live in Newport in the bay, crabbing, and you're watching.
So the Newport Seafood and Wine Festival was a lot of fun. I don't know if you noticed, but I'm actually lying down because I really can't stand anymore. Lots of wine, lots of drinks, lots of fun. And if you notice right on my crotch, there's a crab. That just kind of sort of happens at the Newport Seafood and Wine Festival.